next one topic is ethernet. Ethernet is nothing but the wired LANs. So we learned that local area network. In local area network is a computer network that is designed for a limited geographic area such as a building or a campus. Although a local area network can be used as an isolated network to connect computers in an organization for the sole purpose of sharing resources. Most local area networks today are also linked to a wide area network or the internet. The LAN market has several technologies such as Ethernet, Token Ring, Token Bus, FDDI and ATM LAN. Some of these technologies survived for a while, but Ethernet is by far the dominant technology. The relationship of the 802 standard to the traditional open source interconnection model is shown in the figure 13.1. The IEEE has subdivided the data link layer into two sublayers, logical link control LLC and media access control MAC. IEEE has created several physical layer standards for different LAN protocols. This is a diagram that represents the IEEE standard for local area networks. So this one is the logical link control LLC and this one is the media access control MAC. Upper layer, this one is the upper layers. In data link layer, which has the LLC, Ethernet MAC, Token Ring MAC, Token Bus MAC. In physical layer, which has the Ethernet physical layers, Token Ring physical layer, Token Bus physical layer. This is the transmission medium that is for IEEE standard, and this is the transmission medium for OSI or internet model. Data link layer. As we mentioned before, the data link layer in the IEEE standard is divided into two sublayers, LLC and MAC, logical link control LLC. So in chapter 11 we discussed data link control. We said that data link control handles framing, flow control, error control. In IEEE project 802, flow control, error control and part of the framing duties are collected into one sublayer called the logical link control. Framing is handled in both the LLC sublayer and the MAC sublayer. The LLC provides one single data link control protocol for all IEEE LANs. In this way, the LLC is different from the media access control sublayer MAC, which provides different protocols for different LANs. The purpose of the LLC is to provide flow and error control for the upper layer protocols that actually demand these services. Media access control. In chapter 12 we discussed multiple access methods including random access, controlled access and channelization. IEEE project 802 has created a sublayer called media access control that defines the specific access method for each LAN. For example, it defines CSMACD as the media access method for Ethernet LANs and the token passing method for token ring and token bus local area networks. Standard Ethernet. The original Ethernet was created in 1976 at Drax Palo Alto Research Center. Since then, it has gone through four generations. So we briefly discuss the standard or traditional Ethernet in this section. MAC layer, that is physical layer, we are going to discuss in this section. Ethernet evaluation through four generations. Ethernet evaluation. Ethernet standard Ethernet 10 megabits per second, fast Ethernet 100 megabits per second, gigabit Ethernet 1 gigabits per second, 10 gigabit Ethernet 10 gigabits per second. MAC sub layer. In standard Ethernet, The MAC sublayer governs the operation of the access method. It also frames data received from the upper layer and passes them into the physical layer. 802.3 MAC frame. So this is the preamble SFD, which has totally 8 bytes physical layer header. SFD is nothing but a start frame delimiter, which has a flag which has a bits 10101011, and preamble which has a 56 bits of alternating ones and zeros. This is the destination address which has the 6 bytes, source address which has 6 bytes, length or type which has 2 bytes, data and padding. Last one is the CRC which has the 4 bytes. Frame format. Preamble. The first field of the 802.3 frame that contains 7 bytes, that is 56 bits of alternating zeros and ones, that alerts the receiving system to the coming frame and enables ACE to synchronize its input timing. The pattern that provides only an alert and time pulse. SFD, that is start frame delimiter, the second field 1 byte 10101011 signals the beginning of the frame. The SFD warns the station that this is the last chance for the synchronization. Destination address DA. The DA field is 6 bytes and contains the physical address of the destination station or stations to receive the packet. Source address SA. The SA field is also 6 bytes and contains the physical address of the sender of the packet. Length or type. This field is defined as the type field or length field. The original Ethernet used this field as the type field to define the upper layer protocol using the MAC frame. Data. This field that carries data encapsulated from the upper layer protocols. It is a minimum of 46 and a maximum of 1500 bytes. CRC. The last field contains error detection information. In this case, a CRC is 32 we are using. This is a minimum and maximum length. Destination address 6 bytes, source address 6 bytes, length PDU 2 bytes, data and padding CRC bytes. In data and padding, minimum payload length 46 bytes and maximum payload length of the data and padding is 1500 bytes. So totally, which has the minimum frame length from this to this is 512 bits or 64 bytes, and maximum frame length is 12144 bits or 1518 bytes. Frame length, so minimum 64 bytes, that is 512 bits, and the maximum 1518 bytes, that is 12144 bits. Addressing. Each station on an Ethernet network, such as PC, workstation or printer, has its own network interface card, that is NIC card. The NIC fits inside the station and provides the station with the 6 byte physical address. Unicast, multicast, broadcast addresses A. Source address is always a unicast address. The frames come from only one station. The destination address, however, that can be unicast, multicast or broadcast. The figure 13.7 that shows how to distinguish a unicast address from a multicast address. If the least significant bit of the first byte in a destination address is 0, the address is unicast. Otherwise, it is a multicast. This is an example of Ethernet address in hexadecimal notation. 0601-0201-2C4B. Here 6 bytes is equal to 12 hexadecimal digits, which is equal to 48 bits. This is an unicast and multicast address. Unicast address 0, byte 1, multicast 1. Okay, this one is byte 2 up to byte 6. The least significant bit of the first byte defines the type of address. If the bit is 0, the address is unicast. Otherwise, it is multicast. Example. Define the type of the following destination addresses. 4A30102101A. It is an A. This is an unicast address because A is a binary, is 1010. In B, this is a multicast address because 7 is a binary, is 0111. And C, it has 4 Fs. Physical layer. The standard Ethernet defines several physical layer implementations. Four of the most common are shown in the figure 13.8.